Hello and welcome to this tutorial video where I show you how to record your screen using OBS. So here we are, I've opened up OBS. Make sure that you're running the most recent and up-to-date version of OBS Studio. And then once you're here in OBS, I want you to go up to where you see File and then go to Settings. That's going to open up all of the settings here within OBS. Once under Settings, I want you to leave everything the same all the way down to where you see Output. So we don't want to mess with Stream because that's for live streaming, and we just want to go to Output. This is going to be where we change and do everything we need to do to make sure we get the highest quality recording from OBS. All right, we're going to go from the top down. Go ahead and leave Output Mode here at Simple. If you want to get fancy, you can do so later. Everything here under streaming, we don't even touch. We just go ahead and scroll down to the recording section. Here under recording, we want to go to recording path. Go ahead and click browse and select a folder on your PC where you want the files to live. So basically when you record something and hit stop record, that's going to be where that file lives. Next, it's going to be recording quality. Now I like to leave mine at high quality, medium file size, but again, you can choose depending on the type of PC that you're using. If you want this to be lossless quality, you can see it's going to be extremely large file sizes. I've recorded 1080p, 4K with great results using the high quality medium file size. Now, recording format is going to be the format in which the recordings export in. So for me, I like mine to be exported into .mp4 or MPEG-4 files. This just works with most editing softwares, and it plays nicer with the things that I do with the video files. So you can choose whatever file format you like, but I certainly prefer MP4. Next is going to be video encoder. Now this is quite important. If you select the drop-down menu here, I have it selected to the NVENC because I have an NVIDIA graphics card. Okay, now you might want to Google and see what might work best with your specific graphics card, but if you're working with NVIDIA, this is the one to choose here. And if you're using something else, you may want to Google just to make sure you're selecting the proper one. Next would be audio encoder. Leave that the same. Leave that at default. Once we've done all of that here under recording, we now want to go to the audio tab on the left-hand sidebar. Audio is very important. Leave the sample rate and channels alone unless you want to export into mono. I would assume you want to do stereo, but again, you can play around with that if you'd like. The two audio sources are going to be our desktop audio. So when you're playing a game or the audio coming from your PC, that audio is going to be recorded from whatever your speakers are. So for some people, you might want to leave that at default, but you want to do some test recordings just to make sure you're utilizing the correct sources. For me, my speakers are going to be the Realtek digital output here, so that's going to be the audio format for my desktop audio. Next would be your mic audio or auxiliary audio. For me, I use my Rodecaster or Rodecaster Pro Studio as my audio interface, so I have my Shure SM7B audio microphone plugged into my audio interface, so I know that this is the one that I want to use. But if you have like a Blue Yeti plugged in via USB, that should pop up here. And if you have it set up properly in your audio settings on your PC, you can just use default and you should be good to go. But as with all of these settings, we'll want to test these once we have all of this set up just to be sure. You can always go in and add multiple microphones if you have a studio set up and you're having multiple inputs. I wouldn't mess with that right now, just for simplicity's sake. Next, we want to go over to video. So go ahead and go to the video in the sidebar. And this is kind of complicated, but once you kind of hear it explained, it's not that bad. So the base canvas resolution is going to be the box that you see here within OBS Studio that you can see. So if you're recording a monitor like mine that is 4K, you would have to go in and adjust and drag the corners a bit to get it to fit in the recording, and I'll show you that in a minute. And then I'll move this back up here. The output resolution is going to be what it exports to. So it'll export to 2560 by 1440. But for most people, if you go to 1920 by 1080, that will work. But again, all of this is dependent on the size a resolution of the monitor in which you're recording. So you may want to play around with these a bit, but knowing what your monitor is should help eliminate any problems here. So for me, 2560 by 1440 is what I like to go with. And then under FPS or frames per second, depending on the power of your PC, I would always try to go with 60, but if you see your PC can't handle it, go to 30. But 60 is what I would stick with at first to see kind of where you can handle with your PC. Now, once you've done all of this, make sure you don't hit OK. You need to go ahead and click Apply in the right-hand corner, and then once you've applied that, go ahead and go to OK. So as you can see here, I have a scene set up, but I'm going to do it from the start. So we're going to go down here to where you see scenes, and we're going to click the addition symbol to create a new scene. Name it whatever you want and click OK. So right now under scene, we don't have anything here because we have to add sources. So under sources, right here next to scenes, click on the addition symbol, and that's going to show us all of the different types of sources that we can go ahead and add. So for the case of a recording of our desktop, we want to choose one of a few different things. We have window capture, which is going to capture a specific window. We have game capture, which is going to be set to record a specific game. Like if you're playing, say, Overwatch or whatever, you can have it to capture a specific game. But for simplicity's sake, I would choose display capture. Now, under display capture here, what we can do is we can give it a name and go ahead and go to OK. Now, as you can see, it goes ahead and selects automatic the different display. I have two monitors. If I hit the display dropdown, I can choose between the two. So primary monitor here, and the monitor that I want over here is my other one. So I go ahead and click OK, and as you can see here, it doesn't show my entire screen. So if I click and hold, I can drag this, and I can resize this to be the size of this canvas. So I can go here, and it kind of snaps into place, and as you can see, it's now going to record my entire desktop because I've kind of drug it a little bit and resized it. If you're in 1920 by 1080 and everything syncs up, you shouldn't have a problem, right? That should fit just perfectly, but for me, I can zoom in or out by dragging the corners if I want to. Now, once you've done that, you want to make sure you test everything. So as you can see, my microphone here is picking up the audio as I'm speaking into it, right? You want your microphone to live in this yellow area from about negative 20 to negative 10 dB, maybe even a little below that, but you don't want it capping out in the red because you're going to get some muffled audio and it's going to get those explosives when you're saying your P's. And as you can see here, I'm not even using this microphone to record this tutorial. This microphone's on an arm way up above me and it's still getting picked up. So you want to test that. And you also want to test your desktop audio. And the best way to do that is just to play back some audio like I'm going to do now. So let's play back some audio. And when I play back audio, if I don't see this triggering here, I know that I've picked the wrong source. And now if I play it back, you can see that I'm getting some stuff here from my desktop. So just make sure that you're kind of playing around with that. And I also would encourage you to do some mixing with your audio, because if you're trying to record your microphone on top of your desktop audio as well, you want your microphone to be above the desktop audio. You don't want that to drown you out. So understanding that is an important aspect as well. And then as a bonus tip here, if you did want to record a video like your webcam or for me, my cam link, I can select here under sources. I can go to the addition symbol and then go to video capture device, give it a name, go to OK. And then just select, so like for me, it's going to be Cam Link. And now when I make that visible, you can see that my webcam shows up here on top of my desktop. And if you make the desktop visible, you might have to go here and drag your desktop and you can show your desktop, or you can do vice versa with like your webcam. You can kind of drag and drop, make the desktop kind of bigger here, and you can see it covers up my camera. So whichever one is on top here, so if I put display capture below video capture, then I can play around and select my webcam here, and I can make it come up here on the different sides of the screen, and I can show my webcam as well as my desktop, just like that. If you have any questions about how to do any of this, put it in the comment section below. I try to get to those as quickly as possible. If this helped, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next video.